That's a news conference. That is Jim Kraft, as he is saying right there on one of the local affiliates. Jim Kraft is the police chief. We also heard from the state trooper, the state police colonel, as well as Governor Bobby Jindal. The important facts they made there were right now 10 victims total. We're talking about two victims who were shot and killed. The shooter shot and killed himself, said the police chief, and 7 people were taken to local hospitals, and some of them are in critical condition. If you're just joining us at the top of the hour, you should know there has been a shooting at that place, the Grand Theater, that is in Lafayette, Louisiana. Population about 110,000 there, and about 20 minutes into the 7 o'clock showing of Trainwreck, we're told that an older white man, now we know 58 years old, opened fire on the people in front of him, say witnesses. Police just confirmed a short time ago they do have the identity of the shooter, but they are not yet releasing it. They won't tell us motive. They won't tell us anything else because clearly the investigation is still ongoing. I want to bring in quickly John Arnold. He is a local reporter for the affiliate KADN down there in Lafayette. And John, you heard the police chief talk about the shooter being 58 years old. They know who he is. What are you hearing on the ground there?
Around the theater, they have a bar that's maybe 100, 200 yards in front of the theater, and people said they were outside, and people were actually running out of the theater. They even said one girl from the theater had no shoes on, was running towards the bar. They said people are literally running for their life, not knowing what's going on. Speaking with the Acadian Ambulance, who's the local ambulance service over here, they were talking about when they got the call, they headed there immediately. I got here probably within 15 minutes of the call coming in, and there was already about 20, 30 cop cars here. So the response time was just about as quick as you could have it. As you've heard, the 4 police officers went in there to pursue the shooter. Unfortunately, 3 have been deceased, one of those being the actual shooter himself. But as of right now, everything that Chief Kraft was just saying, that's kind of all we're hearing, except for a couple of people who were saying at the concession stand, they heard a gun go off, lights came on in the theater, and basically everyone was told to exit the theater as quickly as possible. As of right now, there's really no more details, but if there's something else, we'll let you know.
And John, just quickly before I let you go there, the police chief said that all intent or all information they're getting say that this was a lone gunman, that he was not working with anybody else, was not associated with anybody else. I know they won't release his name, but do you have any indication of why they would make that statement?
As of right now, we're not 100% sure just yet. A little early on, we heard a couple of rumors of who it can be. It's been disproved since then. But as of right now, the police chief says they're not sure if he had any motive behind this at all. They didn't know if this was a domestic thing, if this was planned. They said right now it's too early to make a determination on whether this guy planned this or this was really just something that maybe popped into his mind while he was in the theater.
Yeah, again, 58 years old, an older white man who stood up in the back of the theater. And again, nobody asked the question at the news conference, but police earlier said they did not know if this man was actually in the theater from the start or if he came into the theater after the movie started. So that's a key point they'll go over. They have no idea what his motive was or exactly where he was sitting. We should point out, as we still keep John Arnold on the phone with us, we should point out that police are still conducting an active perimeter around the movie theater right now. They believe the building is secure and everybody has been removed from that theater, but still they have an active perimeter because the investigation will go not through the night, but it will go on for several days. And John Arnold, one more question for you, because you're on the scene there, you're kind of our eyes and ears for this. Do you see any more police activity, police showing up? What are you hearing in your area right now?
As of right now, there hasn't been any other emergency personnel showing up. About 20, 30 minutes ago, you had about 3 different crime scene investigations showing up. Right now, all law enforcement is right in front of the theater. There's only so close that you can get. But to kind of backtrack to your last question, saying you weren't sure if he was in the theater to begin with, the rumors are right now, from what we're hearing from people who were supposedly in the theater, was that the shooter was possibly sitting somewhere near the top of the theater when the incident occurred. As of right now, we can't say that's 100%, but from what we're hearing from possible people who were inside of that theater, that's about all we have to go on right now as the police continue their investigation.
Yeah, and it's very good information, John Arnold from KADN. John, thank you very much for your help. You know, you look at the scene there, and we keep going back to the really the only experience we have with this type of thing, which is in Aurora, Colorado. And that was a much different scenario because James Holmes, remember, had walked into an exit door and opened fire on the front of the theater. That's why it's important to figure out, was this planned? Did he get the gun inside? We all know that movie theaters don't have metal detectors, very easy to bring things inside there. So we don't know exactly what the check process was inside this theater. They started to crack down in the wake of the Aurora shooting, but then in the months and the years after that, things kind of got back to normal. Again, you will see a tightening of security at theaters around the country because of this. But again, it's important to point out that a 58-year-old man, as Pat Brosnan, the former NYPD detective, said earlier, 58-year-old man kind of rules out some people. Remember, all those who are associated with ISIS and terrorist groups in the Middle East have been younger. So that kind of ruled him out. Police believe that he, in fact, did act alone. We have now been told the FBI is on scene. The FBI is involved. That seems like a natural progression of things. So we have the state police involved, the sheriff, as you just saw right there, as well as the local police, every first responder there. And now we hear the FBI is also involved in this as the investigation goes on. Again, we're going to go live to the O'Reilly Factor. Take that back. We're going to go to the O'Reilly Factor in moments, but just to give you one quick update here, there has been a shooting in Lafayette, Louisiana. It is in the Grand Theater. It happened in the 7 o'clock showing of Trainwreck. 20 minutes into the showing, we're told a 58-year-old man got up and started shooting at the people in front of him. As for right now, the numbers are this. The shooter is dead from a self-inflicted gunshot wound. Two victims were also dead. We do not know their ages or their gender. And we know that 7 people were also injured, and the police chief says that some of those injuries are thought to be critical. The investigation is still ongoing. The governor, Bobby Jindal, is there. Bobby Jindal said that people weren't running away. People were actually running toward the shooter, trying to stop him. We are following this throughout the evening, breaking news as it happens in Lafayette, Louisiana. I'm Trace Gallagher at the Breaking News Desk in Los Angeles. More details as we get them.